Hello everyone, welcome to Abhipedia, powered by Abhimanyu IAS. Today we are going to do a topic on Indo-Japan Cybersecurity Deal. This topic is from your GS2 syllabus that talks about international relations and agreement of our India with other countries. It also covers GS3 topic, cybersecurity. In this cybersecurity deal, we are going to discuss critical information infrastructure. We are going to discuss 5G technology, what is it and what are its impact. We are also going to discuss what is the cyber law framework in the country. And we are also going to discuss in brief Indo-Japan relationships in the recent. So basically, India and Japan foreign ministers had a strategic dialogue recently and they signed a memorandum of cooperation and they pledged for free and open Indo-Pacific region. Following key cooperation areas were signed regarding 5G network, critical information infrastructure, Internet of Things and artificial intelligence. Critical information infrastructure defined in the IT Act, Information Technology Act 2000, as those computer resources jinke destruction se there will be weakening effect on the nation's economy, public health and safety. National Critical Information Infrastructure Protection Center, NCIIPC, is a nodal organization that has been formed by Government of India under IT Act of 2000, made in 2014. This is basically to protect the critical information infrastructure, and it is a unit under NTRO, National Technical Research Organization. NCIIPC has broadly identified critical sector as power and energy, banking, financial services and insurance, telecom, transport, government strategic and public enterprise. We are basically trying to make sure that our critical information infrastructure stays safe and secure. Cybersecurity Memorandum of Cooperation is to enhance cooperation in the areas of mutual trust, such as capacity building in cyberspace, protection of critical infrastructure, sharing information on cybersecurity, developing joint mechanism for practical cooperation to mitigate cyber threats. What is the significance of this deal? First significance is this, that it will attract stakeholders such as investor in the 5G sector in India, and it will increase the usage of 5G technology, development of technology would be there and more employment would be created, as well as it will increase the country's GDP. We are also trying to make sure that Chinese companies do not get edge of the 5G technology and they will not be allowed to participate in the 5G arena in India due to recent Indo-China tensions. Also, there has been increasing cybersecurity threat due to Chinese cyber attacks and hybrid data warfare by China. Japan is also trying to upgrade its cybersecurity as it has been repeatedly hit by cyber attacks this year, and Deloitte has ranked Japan as fourth in terms of cybersecurity vulnerability. Cyber warfare is the internet-based conflict that involves politically motivated attack on information and information system of a country. Cyber warfare attack can disable official website, network, disrupt or disable essential services, steal or auto-classify data and cripple financial systems. We have also seen that during COVID-19, there has been increased dependence towards the technology, and we need to make sure that cyberspace is safer. What is 5G? Well, it is a fifth generation cellular technology that has increased data speed and reduced latency. Latency means the time taken by a network to respond. It has about a speed of 1 Gbps, which is 100 times higher than the existing data speed. It also increases energy efficiency and offers more stable network applications. What are the applications of 5G? Apart from high-speed mobile network, entertainment and multimedia services, it ensures smart city, smart farming, telemedicines, critical controlling of critical infrastructure and vehicle, industrial applications. 5G will help to incorporate artificial intelligence in our daily lives, and it also facilitate the system ecosystem for Internet of Things. So basically, it will lead to increase in GDP as well as increase in employment generation of the country. Impact of 5G as per World Economic Forum is that it impacts the positively impacts the fourth industrial revolution, and it will be better realized with the help of 5G technology deployment. It will also increase global economic value by $13.2 trillion by the year 2035 and will generate about 22.3 million jobs. Cyber law in India. We have Information Act of 2000, which is the primary law that is dealing with cyber crime and digital commerce in the country. IT Amendment Act of 2008, cyber security, has following sections such as Section 43 for data protection, Section 66 for hacking, 66A for measures against sending offensive messages, 66B punishment for illegally possessing stolen computer resources, 67 protection against unauthorized access to data, 69 cyber terrorism, 70 securing access to attempting or to secure access to a protected system, 72 privacy and confidentiality. Third is our cyber security policy 2013. It is basically aimed at securing cyberspace for Indian citizens and businesses. Next is National Technical Research Organization, which is the main agency to protect the national critical infrastructure that we have already discussed under NCIIPC. Next is Indian Computer Emergency Response System, which is responsible for incident response, including analysis, forecast, and alerts on cybersecurity issues and breaches. India is ranked 23rd by UN Global Cybersecurity Index in the year 2017. Indo-Pacific region. India and Japan both have similar vision for the Indo-Pacific region. They both respect rule of law, sovereignty, and territorial integrity. Both want to counter increasing Chinese aggression in the region. India has launched Indo-Pacific Ocean Initiative at the East Asia Summit in the year 2019. It aims to ensure a stable, secure maritime domain, and the countries like Japan, Australia, Thailand have already supported this initiative. It aims at two things. One is to maintain a stable, maritime, safe and secure maritime domain. Secondly, to make sure that the partnership countries uses the marine resources sustainably. Right? And Japan, Australia, Thailand already have supported this initiative. Countries like ASEAN are expected to support it in the near future. Recent development between India and Japan. Well, both countries have signed logistic agreement that will allow the armed forces from both countries to coordinate in service and supplies. This agreement is called Acquisition and Cross Service Agreement. India and Japan have held their first ministerial dialogue, 2+2 dialogue, in which the defense minister and foreign minister participates from each side. Both countries are also part of Quad Quadrilateral Security Dialogue, which has India, Japan, USA and Australia. There is going to happen second ministerial Quad meeting in Japan. India and Japan both have upgraded their relationship to Special Strategic and Global Partnership. They have also come up with Comprehensive Economic Partnership Agreement in the year 2011 that covers trade, goods, services, movement of natural persons, investment, intellectual property rights, custom procedure and other related issues. India and Japan Defense Forces organize a series of bilateral exercise named JIMEX, Shinyu Maitri, Dharma Guardian. Both countries have also participated in Malabar exercise along with USA. So basically, we want the sophisticated technology from Japan, and we are going to provide raw material, labor, and software expertise. Merging of these two will benefit both nations. India will be better able to realize the vision of Make in India. Also, closer cooperation is required to combat China's growing presence in Indo-Pacific and Asian region. We have to counter China not only in the physical space but also in the digital space. I hope this helped you to understand cybersecurity deal in detail. Thank you. Please like, share and subscribe our channel.